Chase Slate Edge financial expert and founder and CEO of My Fab Finance, Tonya Rapley, has a scoop on how to stay fiscally fit, especially since we're getting towards the end of the year. So welcome to the show.
So this new normal looks different for quite a few people, but a 2021 Chase Slate credit survey found that 81% of people were actively trying to improve their credit score post-pandemic. So that means in the new normal, a lot of people are looking to make credit-based financial decisions, or they just want to improve their finances. Credit-based financial decisions could be things such as buying a home or buying a car. And so if we're thinking about that, you want to make sure that you're using all the tools available to you. And one of those tools could be finding a credit card that has benefits. I know, as you know, as a financial expert and someone who worked on improving her credit score a few years ago, almost 9 years ago, a credit card was a valuable tool. And one of the things I love about the Chase Slate Edge card is it's a unique card designed to have an APR that decreases by 2% each year. It doesn't have an annual fee. You get those automatic credit limit increases with your minimum spend and paying on time within 6 months, as well as you have other benefits such as access to the Chase Credit Journey tool. So that's really helpful, and it's going to allow people to hopefully reach their credit goals quicker.
Yeah, and you also have some more advice to stay fiscally fit. What do you have for us?
Yeah, so some people need that accountability when it comes to improving their finances. And for others, you know, the accountability is their credit report. And so you want to make sure that you're checking your credit report regularly, because it's very hard to change what you do not track. And one of the things I love, and as I mentioned, the Chase Credit Journey tool, is it's going to give you those alerts in case anything changes as it relates to your credit report. It's also going to give you access to your credit scores, and it's going to give you personalized recommendations on what you can do to continue to work to improve your credit report. But another thing that people should keep in mind is that you want to make sure that you're paying on time. We stress this as a financial educator and in my industry, but that's important because a 30-day late can drop your credit report by 100 points. Whoa. And that's significant. If you find that you are not able to pay, then reach out to your creditors or lenders to see if they have any programs or they can extend any grace period that allow you to catch up or get your finances in order so that you can get back on track with making those on-time payments.
And I like what you said about it's hard to change what you don't track, because then that's how we see our patterns, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely. And then I also want to add, you want to be honest about your capabilities, right? Because a lot of people, you know, we don't have boundaries when it comes to our finances. We don't have boundaries when it comes to our money. So be honest with yourself. You know, if you're going to put yourself in a situation where your spending is going to be triggered or you're going to overspend, maybe it's best to say no to that for the moment. Or maybe there are activities or events that you want to participate in that do not make sense based on what your financial goals. Mm-hmm. I measure financial success as doing what you said you would do with your money. So it's important to be honest and ask yourself, is this going to prevent me from doing what I said I wanted to do with my money?
All right. Great advice there. Thank you so much. Where can we get more information?
If you want to find out more about the Chase Slate Edge card, you can go to creditcards.chase.com. And there you can also find information about that credit monitoring tool, the Chase Credit Journey tool, which I mentioned. It's free to people, even if you are not a cardholder with Chase.